What is going on, ladies and gentlemen? As you can see by my beautiful background, we are high up in the mountains of Breckenridge, Colorado. I'm taking a little vacation before Advanced Warfare comes out, and it's a little breezy, it's a little sunny out here, and hopefully I'm doing a good enough job of shielding you guys from... That's a hot tub, by the way. It's freaking awesome. There's a hot tub and mountains in the background. So that's why I'm a little late on this week's episode of The Talking Dead that we have on our channel. You guys aren't familiar, I like to review season 5 episode by episode of The Walking Dead, and today we are doing Four Walls and a Roof. That is the third episode in the series, and really quickly I want to point out two things, because this is a new series. Like I said, this is episode 3, and I'm taking your feedback really, really seriously. So, one, you guys love Kelly on the cast. She'll be back for sure. She was a little bit busy this week. Two, I do agree in terms of the video portion. This is better than just pictures, but I think Daisy gameplay might be better. So we're going to try that out for episode number 4. So, and one more thing. It's a little windy, so my freaking page is flopping all over the page place, but I... I'm, like, holding, like, I had a webcam before, and the other time we had a little microphone, so I didn't have to, like, hold this up and then, like, try to flip through pages, so it might be a little sloppy, but, yeah, let's get into it. 90 seconds in, thank you guys for your patience. I had a few things to say. So, anyways, Four Walls and a Roof is the title of this week's episode, and I thought that was kind of interesting because later on in the episode, Maggie says, or the pastor says, "This is God's house." And Maggie's like, "No, it's not. It's just four walls and a roof." And in episode number 2 of season 5, the pastor was like, Rick was like, "Thank you for your communion wine." And he was like, the pastor was like, "It's not communion wine. It's just wine, because no one's here to take communion." So I just thought it was the religion before and after... before the apocalypse. I thought that was kind of interesting. So I moved over a little bit. I noticed it started to get kind of windy, so I moved up a little bit. Isn't that all... Oh my god, there's mountains. Like, I was seeing it on the camera, then I looked back, and it doesn't show as good on the camera as it does in real life. There's freaking mountains all around. I like mountains, by the way. So it's a little dark here. There's, like, I'm in a little corner of darkness. And then... it starts off with the Terminus guy saying, "Join us." Like, we gave people the choice to join us or feed us. It didn't seem like they gave any of the group a choice to join them. And I do. But then again, Rick went in there kind of hostile. But some other people went in there just like, "We're looking for sanctuary." And they just straight up ate them. Like that hippie guy. I don't know if they didn't give any backstory, but I'm assuming, I mean, they did come from a different cell block, but they just straight up killed them. They didn't give them a choice to join them, because I think the hippie guy would have joined Terminus just to live. I think anyone would. The Terminus guy has Bob and a few friends in, like, a school. They're eating Bob's leg and stuff. So that's how it's starting off. And then Terminus, he says that they saw Carol and Daryl escape in a car, and I was kind of confused on who was in the bushes on episode 2, so he kind of clears that up. And then they say, "Pretty women taste better," which I agree. I think if I'm going to eat some, like, a person, I don't want to ever think about this, but if it ever does happen, oh my god, it's so freaking bright out. The sun just... is evil right now. So if I would have to eat, I think it would, like, start off sexual with, like, me, you know, sucking a titty or something and then taking a bite out of it. I don't know. I think that's how you would ease into cannibalism. Kind of a slow segue or transition. I don't know. But he says pretty women taste better. That's what popped in my mind. I'm kind of sick, I guess. And then I think the best... moment in that whole entire episode is when Bob says, "You idiots," or what does he say? I wrote it down. "You stupid pricks." I'm tainted meat. And then he just starts screaming, I'm tainted, like kind of crazy, but like it almost, it seems like he was overfilled with joy that he, like, he took these people out with him, or just, I thought that was a fantastic moment in the episode. I'm tainted meat. That was so great. Bob always has a lot of lines that are just fantastic in the show. And I would keep screaming if I was in that situation, because there's zombies all around this elementary school or middle school. I forgot which one it was. But they were just like, you know, pounding on the glass all around them. I'm assuming there's a fence around the school as well, and the zombies are around there too. And he was just, I would just keep screaming, because at that point, you know, they ate your leg in front of you. There's no, like, being their friend anymore. There's no getting past that. So, I thought in my personal situation, I would just scream right there. And he said, don't worry. The Terminus guy said, don't worry, because I cooked it. And I think that was a pretty good line by the directors, because you can cook a lot of pork. If you don't cook pork, you can get sick, I believe, to a certain, like, degrees. And that was kind of the same with this apocalypse. So, like, burning things, like, you can boil water to get the stuff out of it if you're ever in a zombie survival situation. Remember, that's why you're watching my videos. I'm going to keep you guys alive out there. So, I just thought that was pretty interesting that they... I don't think they got infected from eating Bob's leg because they cooked it. I'm tainted meat. So then they cuts to the group, Rick and the group in the church, and they're like interrogating the pastor. And in that situation, like I would think anybody's guilty. Like they thought the pastor was guilty for a while until the pastor, you know, starts saying this horrible story about how he kept people out of the church. In the beginning, like, I think it sounded worse when he said it was just at the start of the zombie apocalypse where he kept everybody out. And that was, like, scumbag pastor for real. That was horrible. And then they kind of trusted him after that a little bit more. And actually, later in the episode, Sasha says thank you to the pastor for offering Bob a couch. So I think the pastor is cool now in their book. But he locked the doors, and it was like the people, like, knocking on the doors attracted the zombies towards them. That's crazy. That's crazy. So then they find Bob outside somehow, and there was, like, a whistle before they found him. That's how they noticed somebody was outside. It was a whistle, and I don't know if Bob limped over there. I don't think he did, because there was a big A. Actually, I have to flip this page, so thank you, Wind. There was a big A on the church written in blood. So I think the Terminus people dropped Bob off there and started, like, camping the church, because I don't think he could have limped over there. So I think that they, like, were camping the church, because later in the episode they said, we were watching you and we noticed the group left and stuff. So then it's Rick versus the army guy. There's always Rick versus the army guy, it seems like, in this fifth season. But the army guy recruits Glenn and Maggie to go with him on this journey. And I don't know, Glenn and Maggie were kind of like, sorry, Rick, we're peacing out here. And then Rick was like, no. And then Glenn was like, it's not your decision, Rick. And yeah, Rick is on the army guy's side, or Glenn and Maggie are with the army guy. And then Bob's in the deathbed. And like I said earlier, Bob always has these awesome lines. Sasha's like, why didn't you tell me? And Bob was like, if I told you, it would have just been about the end. And I really liked the middle part. And then Sasha turns to cry. Bob's a smooth motherfucker. I'm surprised Bob didn't beg Bashode, Carol, and Sasha at the same time, because Bob has some lines. So the group goes off to attack Terminus, and then Terminus is watching them, and then in the same scene, Terminus starts walking towards the church. And then, with ease, with so much ease, the Terminus people break into the church. And then I was thinking about earlier in the episode when the pastor was like, I locked the doors and the whole congregation was like banging on the church doors. But literally within 5 seconds, they put like a knife in the door hinge and like kick it and it opens up. So I don't know exactly if the pastor was telling the truth, if the doors deteriorated in the zombie apocalypse or what, but it was very, very easy to get in the church with Terminus. And then, like I said, I believe I called this in episode one of this series, Judith cries as the Terminus people are walking through the church, pretty much saying, we know the group left, we know who's in here, we're armed, come out now. And freaking Judith cries and snitches. So they're like either in one or two doors, and Judith kind of ruined it and let them know what door they were in. Behind door number one, a baby, a bastard pastor, and Carl. Behind door number two, the savior of the zombie apocalypse. So anyways, and then right about the time that the guy from Terminus, the leader, I forgot his name. They mentioned his name. It doesn't really matter what his name is. He's about to shoot the door hinge. Rick, with a silencer, takes out two people. And then the guy, the leader of Terminus, was like, Rick, we will shoot these doors. And then Rick, right, like, perfect aim, shoots off his two fingers. And then they all go to the ground, besides that one asshole from episode one of the series that Tyrese beat up. He actually was alive. I thought he was dead, but he ended up surviving the Tyrese attack. I thought Tyrese killed him at first, but I guess not. So he's like, there's always a choice, and he wants to, like, fight back against the group, and then the army guy comes out from the shadow, says, you wanna bet? And he always has these freaking lines, or like he was talking to Eugene earlier, and he was like, Eugene was like, I don't want to go, and he was like, no, like he always had, like he summons the devil from his vocal box every time he tries to do like this very intense line or like badass line, no, wanna bet. So then they all go to the floor, and then Rick, I thought it was cool that he made his promise, killing him with this red machete with the handle. I thought that, like, this is the second time that this happened this season. I thought the guy that got beat up by Tyrese was dead, and I thought the Terminus guy was dead after he got shot on the top of the roof, but apparently not. They just made it look dramatic for television purposes. So then the Terminus guy says there's no point in begging, right? But there has to be a reason why you didn't kill us. And I didn't want to waste the bullets, Carl. Rick fucking had a line, too. There's been some lines in this episode. I'm very impressed by this episode. And I'm excited to see where it goes, because Bob is dreaming. Then, you know, after they kill and massacre the whole Terminus group, so that kind of storyline is over. And then it cuts to Bob dreaming. And then he's smiling, and then Sasha's like, why are you smiling? And it was like, I had a dream that you were smiling back at me. And then she starts to smile, and dude, Bob's a slick motherfucker, man, I'm telling you. And then Sasha was hoping for another line from Bob, and she says, what's the good that comes from this? And that's when Bob dies. He didn't have a line for that. I don't know, that was good writing. I liked how it went. What's the good that comes from this? And Bob dies. R.I.P. Bob. I really like Bob. I wanted to see if he was going to be the last person that survives from this group, because the backstory from Bob is he was in one group, everybody died, he went to another group, everybody died, then he was on the road, and, he was on the road, and then I believe Glenn and Daryl found him, and he was just so happy. He had a really good attitude. Then he thanks Rick for helping him, picking him up. He didn't realize there was any good people left in the zombie apocalypse. And then Rick and the army guy split up, Maggie and Glenn leave with the group, and it wasn't much of a goodbye. Like, it just, it felt like an awkward camp, like the end of camp. I don't know, it just was a really awkward goodbye. They didn't really hug or anything. They were just, like, sitting in the bus looking at the group, and then they, for, like, 10 seconds, and then they left. I don't know exactly what happened there. I am assuming it's because Rick and the army guy and Glenn and Maggie are going to meet up again. And the reason why Rick and Maggie stayed, or Rick and the group stayed, is because they're waiting for Daryl and Carol to come back. And that's what leads us to the final scene of season 5, episode 3, Four Walls and a Roof of The Walking Dead. So it's the pastor and Michonne talking just about, like, just sad shit in the zombie apocalypse and how they deal with it and stuff. And then they hear, like, a rustle in the bushes, and the pastor immediately runs inside, which I thought was funny. And then Michonne goes, she actually finds her sword from one of the dead people in Terminus, so I thought that was awesome too. Michonne got her sword back. And I don't know, is Carol the number one bad bitch? She didn't, nothing really happened with Carol this episode, so Michonne might be creeping back into that spot. So then she goes to the bushes, and it's Daryl, and Daryl says, "Come on out." And then it ends. So I'm hoping that Carol's there. I'm hoping that Beth is there. And I'm hoping that pastor, or that the cremationtist, funeralist from season 3, when Beth got kidnapped, I hope that it's a group of them. We'll see what happens. You know, Walking Dead always seems to surprise us. But I wouldn't count out those people being with the group. And then, I don't know, maybe there's some beef between the pastor and this other guy, and the pastor was lying or something. I don't know what's going to happen. So yeah, leave this video a like if you watched 17 minutes in. Help the series grow and continue. I'm going to enjoy the rest of my vacation here. We got one more day. We've got to relax. The beautiful mountains are in the background. Oh, that's a good shot. I'm sorry if this, like, I was like, like, I don't know, I was doing a whole bunch of different movement with the camera and stuff, but that's just because I was trying to protect you guys from the wind, and also not get, like, the sun in my eyes, and I did my best, and, yeah, tomorrow, season 5, episode 4, what will happen in the Walking Dead zombie apocalypse? Will Rick and the group of Maggie army guy and Glenn recombined and re... Okay, I should have just ended this a while ago. I'm sorry. Headbutt!